Hello friends, welcome to C# intermediate to advanced tutorial. Now you are watching the part 3 of this subseries stream reader and stream writer. So in this part we are going to use the path utility, and using that utility we will check the file extension. After checking the file extension, whether when the file extension is BMP, then we will load the image into the picture box control. So we can quickly review what are all the content we have seen in the previous two videos. So previously we opened the file open dialog and we left here. Now in this part we will write code inside this portion. That means here dialog result is okay. That means it states that user selected some file. So first what we will do, we will check whether the opened file is BMP or image file, then we will write a code for it. So if you see here, user selected a BMP file using the file open dialog. So the control here displays the picture. So from the design, we are already aware that we placed two control on top of each other. One is the picture box control, and another one is a text box control with multi-line property set to true. And here if you see, when dialog result is okay, so first we displayed the dialog using the dlg file open. So this is the file open component, show dialog. So this is a blocking call. User will pick some file and click OK. So here if you see, we are using the file name property on the file open dialog. So this will return whatever file picked by the user. So first we are assigning that to the text box. If you see here in the about text box, we are seeing user selected test.bmp from g partition temp folder. So first we want to check whether user picked any image file. So for that we are making use of the path utility class. So the get extension will give only the extension path. Here extension path is a bmp, so get extension will return that BMP, and we have BMP stored here in the extension. ext will store BMP. Here in this case it stored BMP, but if you selected text file, then it will store the extension txt. So first we are making sure the selected extension is not txt. That means if you remember, when we click the file open, we set three filters. One is a filter for JPEG image, and another one is the filter for BMP image, and the next extension is a txt. So these are all the three supported extension. So if the extension is not txt, then the selected file may be BMP or JPEG, or it can be any file because of a star dot star extension. So first, let's assume that user selected BMP or a JPEG file. We will talk about some other file extension, say a log file. So this validation we will do later. But for now, if selected extension is not TXT, let's assume it's a BMP or JPEG. So here we will write code for it. We know that this portion displays two controls on top of each other. One is the text box control to display the multi-line text. Another one is the picture box control. So since here we make sure that the extension is not TXT, that means it's an image file display. First, we set the visible property of a text file content to false. Then picture control, we are making it as visible. After that, we use the picture box size mode to stretch image. In the previous video series, we talked about picture box control. So by this time, you know what is mean by stretch image, and we are setting that to the size mode property. So stretch means, if you see the, so this is the image, right? Let's say the image is only this much in size, some pentagon, circle, and some shape. But if you see, this image is stretched widthwise as well as heightwise. So that's the stretch image constant, which we set to the size mode property of the picture box control. So after setting these two properties, we are making call to the load method of the picture box control. Then the file name, whatever user picked, that we are passing it here. So that means we are asking to load G drive test.bmp. Right, this is what a user picked using this file open dialog, and we are passing it here. So this will load the selected picture file into this control, picture box control. So picture box control is visible, and the multiline text box is made as not visible. All right, now it is a demo time. We will go ahead and make use of the path utility class to find the extension of the selected file. So this is where we left in the previous part. So we displayed the dialog, and then user selected OK. We displayed a message box also. So if you see here, first we are getting the file name from the file open dialog. So we display that in the text file, I mean in the text box. Then we use that same property, file name, and we are getting extension of user selected file. So when the extension is not a TXT, we assume user selected a BMP or a JPEG file. So as already explained in the slide, we are setting the picture box control to visible, and we hide the text file, I mean multiline text box control. Then we set size mode property to stretch image. After that, we open the file using the load method. Now we will execute this. So this is our control. So I'm clicking the file open dialog. Okay, we have only text file here. We'll go to temp one. There is no BMP file. We have a JPEG file. So I'm picking that file and I'm clicking open. Now the extension is not TXT, so it's JPEG. That's all. So now we opened picture box I mean, we've opened the picture into the picture box control. And you can also see the text box is populated with the selected file name. Here we are setting it, right? So it's populated here. Extension, we used the get extension method. So that's all here. So we completed displaying the image in the picture box control using the file open dialog. Also, we make sure the selected file extension falls under BMP or JPEG. So now this will have an error also. Say for example, this is txt, let's leave that. Yeah, here we have one log file, right? So if I select it, we'll get exception. Why? Because here we are checking for when extension is not txt, we are assuming all the files as BMP. So one quick fix here is removing this file filter. So that means the user can select only a specific file, JPEG or TXT or PMP. So the existence of ** makes user to select a log file, and there we end up with an error. But this error is, we implemented it on purpose. In further going video, we will see handling the error from this file open dialog. Alright, so we completed loading the picture, and by this time you know how to use the file utility class to get the extension. That's all here in this video. Thank you for watching. Bye.